Finite automata or finite state machine, what is it? It is basically a machine model which is used to recognize the regular languages. So we are going to use this finite automatas, which is a theoretical machine, okay, machine model, to recognize the regular languages. So tomorrow, suppose somebody gives you a string, and we are supposed to find out whether the given string is accepted by the regular language. That means given string belongs to regular language or no. Then we have to give that string as input to this particular automata called as finite state machine or finite automata. And finite automata will take this input, it will process the input, and at the end it is going to tell you whether the string is accepted or rejected. Okay, so what is an automata? Automata is also a pictorial representation of the machine. These are basic machine models. Finite automata are basic machine models. And please note that these finite automata, being basic machine models, they do not have any auxiliary memory. Which means that finite automata, they cannot remember strings. They cannot store the input string. So suppose the input string given is of length 5. Then after reading first symbol, second symbol, third symbol, finite automata will not recognize what was the previous symbol, what was the second and the first symbol. It does not recognize. Okay, so how do we get over this? So because automata cannot store symbols read by it, then it responds to the symbol read only by making transitions. Okay, so to respond to this particular deficiency, what automata does is, on reading a particular symbol, it just makes a transition, and transition means changing its current state. Okay, transition means, suppose you are in a particular state, say I, okay, it simply goes to state J. So this is called as transition, moving from one state to a next state or new state, that's called as transition. So finite automata does this transition, and that's how it tries to cope up with the deficiency of not remembering the things, okay, because of lack of auxiliary memory. We shall see this further. Next, a transition table is formed, and it gives the resultant state of the automata when it reads a symbol in a particular state. So, as I'm going to explain you later on what is a transition table, basically I will give you the entire I'll take an example to explain your entire automata. That time I will again come back and I will tell you what exactly transition table is. For now, just remember that, what is transition table? Transition table is a tabular, you could have written the same transitions in a textual way. When the transitions are written in a tabular way, in form of a table, that is transition table. What it gives? It gives the resultant state. It tells you which state your machine will go on reading a particular input and when you are in a particular state. More things we are going to see later. Okay, let's go ahead. Transition is generally defined by a function. Okay, transition is generally defined by a function. So transition is a function which maps the Cartesian product of set of states and input alphabet of the language recognized by automata to the set of states. So these two points you will understand when I'm going to take a live example and I'm going to explain you. So I will revisit these two points that time. Okay. Next we have deterministic finite acceptors, or they are also called as deterministic finite automata, or in short DFA. Okay. So what is the definition of deterministic finite automata? A DFA is defined by a quintuple. Okay, it is defined by tuple with a 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, DFA is basically defined by 5 tuple or quintuple, where each of these elements correspond to what? So, where, what is Q? Q is finite set of internal states. See, automata is basically a machine. It's a finite state machine. So there will be states and there will be a transitions. Okay. Transitions to move from one state to the next state. So automata would be something like this. You will have some states and then there will be some transitions to move from one state to the next state, or maybe next state to the previous state, and so on. Okay, so this is how the automatas are going to be there. So Q is basically what? Q is a set. Okay, Q is a set of all possible states. Okay, in the automata. Okay, so what is Q? Q is a set of all the states in the automata. Fine. So now there are 1, 2, 3 states. So Q, suppose this state is 1, state 2 and state 3, then Q will be 1, 2, 3. So Q is nothing but it is finite set of internal states. Internal state meaning the states which are there in the automata. Let us proceed. Next is sigma. Sigma is nothing but finite set of symbols called as input alphabet. In the introductory video wherein I had explained you regarding the alphabet, strings and languages, we have already come across something called as sigma, that is alphabet set. So alphabet set of a language is nothing but all the strings in that language, okay, they are formed from the set of symbols which are defined in the alphabet set. Now in this case what happens is you will have a finite automata. You will have a finite automata like this. And now what will be given as input to this finite automata? The input given to this finite automata will be nothing but input string. Okay, some string. Okay, and suppose the language is over say 0, 1, then the string which can be given to it as input will be something like 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, whatever. Okay, so sigma is what? Sigma is basically the alphabet set. So the string that will be given as input to this finite automata, that string will be formed from that alphabet set. Okay, so that now since we are talking about the input string and the components of the input string belonging to this alphabet set, sigma is also called as input alphabet or input alphabet set. Okay, so in simple words, set of alphabets present in the input string are stored in this particular sigma. Sigma is the alphabet set. It's the same definition of what we had seen last time. Okay, so let's proceed. Then Q naught. Now Q naught belonging to Q. So if Q is nothing but set of all the possible states, okay, if Q is nothing but set of all states, then Q naught, it belongs to Q. That means Q naught is one of the states in the set of all possible states. So Q naught is one of the state. Now what is this Q naught? It is called as initial state. Now I'll tell you what is initial state. Whenever we have an automata, whenever we have an automata like this, okay, basically there will be transitions defined that will do the processing. But when the input string is given as to the automata, it should be given at certain point. So for this automata to run, there should be something called as a starting point. So usually I use this arrow and I say that this state, for example say 1, this state is a start state. That means whenever input is given, no, input will be first given to this state and from here it will commence then. Okay, so this is called as initial state. So initial state defined by Q naught. Q naught is one of the states present in Q, because Q is set of all possible states that are present in the finite automata. Q naught is one of the states. And what is Q naught? It is called as initial state. Or initial state is also called as start state. So it is like a starting point for your automata to function. Similar to in programming, you have something called as main function, right? So main function is nothing but the entry point to the program, right? So similarly, automata, although there are different transitions that make it move from one state to another, but there should be some starting point. So that starting point is the start state. Now, once the automata starts from a particular state, say Q naught is a start state, and once the automata starts from this starting state, it will just go on doing the processing from one state to second state to third state, and this will go on. okay, it will go on, right? Now after processing, ultimately the automata is going to tell whether the given string is accepted or rejected, right? So how do we know whether the automata is going to accept the string or reject the string? So for that we will have something called a set of final states. So A, we are using a set called as A. Okay, so A is what? It is basically subset of Q. So Q is set of all possible states. A is subset of it. That means A is not one final state. A may contain 1, 2, 3 final state. That means in this finite automata there will be only one start state. So that's why Q naught belongs to Q. Belongs to symbol tells you that Q naught is one element, right? But in an automata, final state, which is a subset of Q, A is a subset of Q. So A may have something like Q2, Q3 in this example, which means that Q2 is also a final state and Q3 is also a final state. So this is basically a notation that is used for final state. Okay, so in a finite automata, there should be exactly one initial state or start state, but there could be more than one final state. And since more than one final state is there, so this subset, this set A is basically a subset of set Q. So what, suppose in this case Q will be Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3, right? So A is what? Out of all possible states, two states are the final states. So A, that is Q2, Q3, two of these states, A will be definitely subset of Q. Whereas Q0 is just one state. Q0 will belong to Q, because Q0 is the only one state which is a final state among this. Fine. So we are going to see this in more details. Just hold on for some time. I am going to take an example and I am going to trace all this. So that time it will be more clear. So after having defined Q, sigma, Q0, A, the first four elements of the tuple, okay, let us now see the fifth element, del. And this del is nothing but, it's called as transition function. So del, which is a cross product of state over input symbol, okay, transition function del is basically a cross product of set of state over set of input symbol. And what it gives, the resultant of this is Q, that set of states, okay, is a transition function. Okay, for any element Q belongs to capital Q and input symbol A belongs to sigma, okay, so that means for any element Q belongs to capital Q, that what is capital Q? Capital Q is set of all possible states. So small Q is just one particular state. Okay, so for any state Q, and again sigma is what? It is input alphabet, set of all, the strings in the input alphabet, they will be chosen from sigma. So let A be one such input symbol, okay, so which means for any state Q in the finite automata and for any input symbol A which is currently scanned, we interpret delta from Q state on reading A, okay, say you go to R. Okay, so how transition function is defined? Delta of Q comma A. I will just tell you now what is delta of Q comma A. Del of Q comma A means, as the state to which finite automata moves if it is currently in state Q and reads or receives the input symbol A. Okay, that means transition function del is written as Q comma A. That means suppose Q is my current state, Q is the current state of the automata and A is the currently scanned input symbol, then from the current state, on reading the current input symbol, I will go to another state called as R. So this is basically the transition function. Okay, so again I will read, for any element Q belonging to capital Q, okay, so I am talking about one state, one particular state, and on reading any input symbol, say one particular input symbol, we interpret del of q comma a is what? That is transition from the current state q on reading a, what happens? So then it goes to r. Okay, now pictorially I can just interpret it this way. Okay, suppose qi is my current state. Okay, then I will just say transition from the current state qi, on reading the input symbol a, I go to qj. Understood? Suppose my current state is qi and I have not written, I am not shown the start state on all. This dot 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 means there might be more states in the beginning. I am not concerned. I am just showing a small part or small section of the big DFA. So suppose currently I am in qi state, okay? And from qi state on reading a, if I go to qj, from qi state on reading a, to go to qj. So this is basically called the transition. This is how transitions are written in finite automata. So now what I will do is, before I take an example and explain you all this, I will just tell you what are the notations which are used. I have already formally used some notations, but now let us see what are the different notations, graphical notation that are used in finite automata. So Q naught is a initial state, or it is a start state. Okay, so Q naught is written how? The initial state is written how? First, okay, this tells you that it's a state, and this arrow like this, it tells you that this state is an initial state. Now please note, although I'm every time saying Q naught is the initial state, but the labels of the state may be different. This is by default we use Q naught, but tomorrow for exam they might simply say let A be the initial state and B be the other state and so on. So label names can be anything, but theoretically, okay, by default we use Q naught as a label, but label names can be user defined, they can change. Okay, so when I am solving problems, I will mostly use Q naught only, but you can use some other notations also. So initial state is nothing but it is the state from where the automata starts reading the symbols in the input. Okay, it is the starting point in the automata. And to denote the initial state, we draw state and there is an arrow, and the arrow does not have any input written on top of it. So that's an initial state. So if this is an automata, you can see that there is an arrow also going from A to B, but that does not mean B is a start state. You see A, there is an arrow connected to A, but it is not coming from any other state. So which means A is the start state. So this is called as a start state. Next we are going to see what is a final state. So final states, we have already told you that a final state is the one if the automata, if the entire input string is already read, there is nothing else remaining to be read in the input string, that time we have to check which state the automata is reached. And suppose automata is reached in one of these states, then which are called as final states, then we say the automata has accepted the input string, otherwise it has rejected the input string. So now here, this is a notation for the final state, concentric circles. Final states, by default I use a label called as QF, F for final. But again the label names of these states can change, user defined. Any other intermediate state in the automata can be just denoted with a circle, okay, and the label inside. So this is the initial state, this is the final state, and this is the intermediate state. Coming back to transitions, transition is depicted with an arrow that connects one state and the other state, and the value which is written on top of the arrow tells you what is the currently input symbol which is being read. So transition, this is a transition with the input I defined on top of it. Okay, so this is a transition. Finally, acceptance by finite automata. When do you say that the finite automata has accepted a given input string? So when the end of the input string is reached, the string is accepted if the automata is in one of its final states, otherwise it is rejected. Okay, so this is how finite automata is said to be accepting the string. So after scanning all the inputs in the input string, if there is nothing else remaining to be read, that time you check your automata and see whether automata is reached in one of its final states, the concentric circle states. And if automata is reached the final state while there is nothing remaining to be read in the input string, that time you say that the given input string is accepted by finite automata, otherwise the string is said to be rejected by finite automata. I'll just take a simple example. Let me consider that this is a finite automata. Assume that Q0 is a start state. Then from state Q1, you go to Q0 on reading input symbol say A. So from Q0 on reading A you go to Q1. Then in state Q1 on reading input string B, no matter how many times, you will always remain in Q1 only. So from Q1, suppose first B is encountered, you will remain in Q1 only. Second B encountered, you will remain in Q1 only. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth and so on. Okay. Then from Q1, suppose A is encountered, then you go to Q2. Now please note that this, whenever you write a self loop over a state, that self loop is an optional. That means, suppose the input string which is read is AA, then from Q0 on reading first A, you will go to Q1. Then from Q1 on reading the second A, you will directly come to Q2, and this will not be processed. This will be processed only when after the first A, if at all B is encountered, then this will be, this transition will be considered. Okay, so this B is optional. Okay, this is nothing but this is something like clean star representation, pictorial representation of clean star. That means this can be repeated 0 times or more times. Right, let us continue. Then from Q2, let's say on reading B, you come back to Q1. Right, and on reading A, you go to Q3 and assume that this Q3 is a final state. Please note, in a finite automata, there can be any number of final states, but I am just considering only one final state. So assume that this is a finite automata. Now, you have already been taught that finite automata or finite machine M is nothing but it's a quintuple, no? Q, sigma, Q0, A and del. Now with respect to this machine which I have drawn, what are these values? So Q is what? Q is set of finite states present in the automata. All the states which are there in the automata will come in the set Q. Whether it is final state or whether it is initial state or final state, those will also come. So Q in this case will be state Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3. So these are all the states present in the automata. That is set Q, capital Q. Now what is sigma? Sigma is nothing but it's an input alphabet. Okay, set of symbols present in the input string. Looking at this example, it is very clear that either input A will be read or input B will be read every time for the machine to make transition. So it is very clear that the input string that is applied to this automata will be of A's and B's only. Correct? So sigma in this case will be A comma B. Which means the language for which this automata is designed, that language is over sigma equal to A comma B. Right? Which means the strings in that language will be only made out of A's and B's. Clear? Now, so Q sigma. Now, what is Q0 in this case? Q0 is a start state. I have given the same name. So, Q0, which is a start state. In my case, it is Q0 only. Again, see, although I have mentioned that Q0 is a start state in the definition, these labels of the states can be user defined. It can be anything. Theoretically, we usually use these notations. But for exam, they can also say that let A be the initial state, let B be the next state and so on. That's fine. User defined labels are okay. But by default, theoretically, we use Q0. Okay. In this case, Q0 is the start state. Then, what is A? A, I told you, it is a set of final states. And I've also told you that A is a subset of capital Q. Now, in this case, since there is only one final state, A will contain Q3. But suppose if there were more final states, say Q2 also was a final state, then A would have the elements as Q2, Q3. So Q2, Q3 will be subset of capital Q. Okay? Now, we will see what is del. So del is nothing but, as I have already told you, del is a transition function. It's a function that defines how transition happens, from which state to which other state on reading what input. So transition function is basically a cross product of a state Q over input segment sigma. Okay, and after making this transition, the automata reaches in another state. Okay, so let's see how the transitions are defined here. Now, what is state set Q? Set Q will be Q0. In my example, set Q is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. These are the elements of set Q. So this is Q, correct? Also, what is sigma? Sigma is A, B. So when you consider cross product, it is every element of one set with every other element of the set. Okay? So the first transition, so let us define the transitions in this. The first transition will be Q0, A. We'll see what answer we get. Second will be Q0, B. So Q0 is over. Then transition from state Q1 on reading A. Then transition from state Q1 on reading B. Over. Okay. Then transition. So Q1 is also over. Q2, A. Transition Q2, B. Then transition Q3, A, and finally transition Q3, B. So why I write cross product here is because when you do the cross product, you are going to get all the possible transitions in this finite automata. Now, what is the meaning of del of Q0, A? It simply means that transition, when you are in a particular state Q0, and in that state Q0, suppose A is read as input, where do you go? So you go to Q1. From state Q0 on reading A, where do you go? You go to Q1. So this is how transition is defined. Now what is Q1? Q1 is one of the states in capital Q, and that's why after this arrow I have written Q. So transition function is nothing but it is basically cross product of a state over an input, and it gives as an output another state where you land after the transition happens, right? So now let's write the transitions, what are the possible transitions of all this. So next is transition from state Q0 on reading B. So when you are in Q0 and when on reading B, do you go anywhere from Q0 on reading symbol B? Any transition is defined? No. So when there is no transition defined, we call this as null transition. Fine. Now, from state Q1 on reading A, you go to Q2. From state Q1 on reading B, you remain in Q1 only. From state Q2 on reading A, you are going to Q3. From state Q2 on reading B, you go to Q1. From state Q3 on reading A, do you go anywhere else? No. So, fine. And from state Q3 on reading B also you don't go anywhere, so this is also 5. So this is how the transitions are written. Finally, now we will see what is the meaning of acceptance by finite automata. What do you mean by finite automata accepting an input? Suppose the input string that is given is, let's consider input string that is given is A, B, B, A. Suppose this is the input string given. Now let's see where the finite automata lands when all the inputs are read. So initially, so these are states. Initially the automata is in Q0 state. Now from Q0 state on reading A, where do you go? From Q0 state on reading A, you go to Q1 state. Agreed? Now when you are in Q1 state, on reading B, where do you go? From Q1 state on reading B, you remain in Q1 state only. Again, when you are in Q1 state and when another B is encountered, where do you go? You go to Q1 state. Q1, second B is encountered, also you will remain in Q1 only. And in this Q1 state, on reading the last A, where do you go? You go to Q2. Now, is there any more input symbol that is remaining to be read? No. At that time, you check what is the state where the automata is landed currently. So, currently the automata is in Q2 state. Then you ask, is Q2 the final state? No, Q2 is not the final state. That's why we conclude that the given input string is not accepted. Or not recognized by DFA. As an example, suppose if you take another input string, say A, B, A, A. Suppose this is the input string that we have taken. So the states I will depict here. Initially we are in Q0 state. So in Q0 state, after reading A, where do you go? You go to Q1 state. In Q1 state, again another A is read. Where do you go? From Q1 state on reading A, you go to Q2 state. Now you are in Q2 state. You read B. Where do you go? You go back to Q1 state. From Q1 state, on reading A again, where do you go? You go to Q2 state. And finally, from Q2 state, on reading A, where do you go? You go to Q3 state. Now, is there anything else remaining to be read from the input string? No, the last input is already read. Now you check, where have you landed in the automata? You are in which state? You are in Q3 state. Is that state a final state? Yes. So that's why you say that this particular string is accepted or recognized by DFA. Okay, so acceptance by DFA is this. And one very important thing is, see, basically this DFA must have been designed for a particular language. Okay, so this DFA will be accepting all the languages, all the strings which belong to that language. So if any string has been accepted by DFA, we say that the string belongs to the language L for which machine M is defined. Okay? Let us now design a DFA for the language, okay, where, okay, so I will just write design a DFA for a language over sigma equal to A comma B, where every string ends with symbol B. Suppose we are asked to design a DFA for this. Okay, designing a DFA for a language over sigma equal to A comma B, where every string ends with B. So how do we solve this kind of problems? So approach is very simple. First, you need to ask yourself, what is the minimum possible string? Okay, in this case, so the language is over A comma B. That means the language will contain all the strings formed from A and B. Fine. Then next you ask, what is the constraint that is put on the language? The constraint is that no matter first half of the string could be anything, okay, but the string should always end with B. So if you ask me to design a regular expression for this, the regular expression would be something like this: A plus B raised to star ending with B. This will be the corresponding regular expression. That means the first half of the string could be any combination of A's and B's, but the string always ends with a B. So this, from this it is very clear that minimum possible string will be B. Right? So now first you need to design a finite automata for that B. Suppose Q0 is my start state. Then string B should be accepted means what? So after reading B, the automata should reach in the final state. So I will just call QF as the final state. And from Q0, on reading symbol B, it should go to the final state. Automata should reach the final state. So what I have drawn is, I have drawn an automata for just one string, which is nothing but the minimum possible string. Right? Next, let us see what are the other possible strings. Okay. So, first half, since it can be anything, any combination of A's and B's. Now let us see, how do we write any combination of A's and B's? Right? So what are the possible strings that I accepted? First, you can have, say, some A's, n number of A's ending with B. This should be accepted. Then B, 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 n number of B's ending with B. This should be also accepted. Then AB, AB, AB ending with B should be accepted. Then BA, 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 n number of BA's ending with B should be accepted. These are the four basic strings that should be accepted. Then these two combination. So some A's, some B's, some A's, and go on till B, and this should be accepted. Now we have taken A's first and B's next. Now we'll take ulta. First B, then A. So then some B's, then some A's, some B's, and this can go on ending with B. This also should be accepted. So we have taken combination of these two. Now let us take combination of these two. So that means AB, BA. So AB, BA, again AB, BA, and this can go on ending with B. This should be also accepted. Now first we have taken AB, then BA. Now take ulta. First take BA, then AB. That should be also accepted. BA, AB, BA, AB, and so on ending with B should be accepted. Now you take combination of these two. Some A's, then AB. Again some A's, then AB. And this can go on ending with B should be accepted. Okay. So then some B's and AB you can take. Some B's and AB. Again some B's and AB ending with B. This should be also accepted. And now some A's and BA you can take. Some A's and BA. Some A's, BA, and so on ending with B should be accepted. And then some B's and BA. Some B's, BA. Then again some B's, then BA, and so on ending with B. And there is more combination, but these are the main basic strings which should work. Okay, so now we will consider each of these strings and we will try to add transitions to this basic automata and try to complete it. Okay, so let us first see whether this string is accepted. Single B, no? So I can just say self loop A. So when I write self loop A, that means this self loop may be considered or may not be considered. When it is considered, you have an option of choosing n number of times. So say 3 A's or A, n number of A's ending with B. It's getting accepted. Right? Next, n number of B's ending with B. From Q0, on reading first B, you go to QF. With single B, the string is already accepted. So no matter how many more B's are there, it will always remain in the final state, right? Because all these are accepted. All substrings where only B is there, it's already accepted. So B, you can just say B, and then any more number of B's, B, 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 it will be still accepted. It will always remain in the final state. So this is also accepted. Next is AB, 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 AB ending with B. So A, B, A, B, A, B, A, B, and you go on and ending with the last B here. So A, B, A, B, A, B, and ending with B. You go to the final state. Accepted, no? Then B, A, B, A, B, A, ending with B. So B, A, B, A, B, A, and go on and ending with B. Accepted. Then some A's, some B's, some A's ending with B. So some A's, first B, any more number of B's. And again first A, any more number of A's. B, any more number of B's. A, any more number of B's. A's, B, any more number of B's. Again, A's, any more number of A's, and finally one B, accepted. Right? Getting it? So, say, example, the string given to us is, say, 2 A's, 2 B's, 2 A's, ending with B. I'm trying it for this one. So, 2 A's, 2 B's, again 2 A's, ending with B, accepted. Or, 2 A's, 2 B's, 2 A's, again 2 B's and ending with B. This also will be accepted. 2 A's, 2 B's, again 2 A's, ending with 2 B's and then B. Accepted. Agreed? Then let's go further. Some A's, some B's, some A's ending with B. Some A's, some B's, some A's ending with B. This is already taken. Now some B's, some A's, some B's and so on. First B, any more number of B's. First A, any more number of A's. Again B, any more number of B's. A, any more number of A's, ending with B. Accepted. Now A, B, B, A, A, B, B, A, ending with B. Okay. A, B, B, A, A, B, B, A, ending with B. Accepted. Then check whether this is accepted. B, A, A, B. So B, A, A, B, B, A, A, B, ending with B. Accepted. Some A's, A, B. Again, some A's, A, B, and so on. Some A's, A, B. Again, some A's, A, B, ending with B. Accepted. Agreed? Some B's, A, B. Again, some B's, A, B. Some B's, A, B. Again, some B's, A, B, okay, and ending with B, accepted. So, ultimately, all others will be accepted. When these basic strings from here to here, okay, if they are all accepted, then others will automatically get accepted. So, this is a finite automata which we have designed. Now, one more thing is, finite automata, how will you know whether this finite automata that you have designed is correct or wrong? Okay, two things should happen. One, all the valid strings should be accepted and all the invalid strings should be rejected. Two is, they don't consider invalid strings to check whether they are rejected. If suppose all the valid strings are accepted, but there also occurs an invalid string which is not accepted, then the automata is wrong. And then we'll have to again redefine some transitions or add more states and so on. Right? So that will come as we are going to solve more problems later on. Okay. So far, this is a simple finite automata. Now, coming back to the first page that I had considered, I told you that there is something called as transition table and I will come to it later. So, transition table is basically all the transitions which are defined, they are in the tabular form. They are defined in a tabular form in transition tables. So, before we go to transition tables, let us quickly define the transitions which are available in this automata. Okay, let us quickly define the transitions which are there in this automata. Before that, what is Q here in this case? In this case, there are only two states. So Q will contain Q naught and QF, set of all possible states. Sigma in this case of mine will be A comma B. Q naught, again I've kept the same name. Q naught is only one element. Q final state A there will be only one final state, QF. Okay, now transition, let us define the transition. So transition from state Q0 on reading A is what? Transition from state Q0 on reading B is what? Let's find out. So Q0 on reading A, you go to Q0 only. Q0 on reading B, you go to QF. That's a final state. Then transition from QF on reading A. From QF on reading A, you go to Q0. Again, transition from QF on reading B. So from QF on reading B, you remain in QF only. So there are only four transitions. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Define. So transition table is nothing but it is the tabular way of representing the textual transitions. So transition table, I will just draw transition table for this. Okay. So the table will contain two columns. You will have states versus the inputs. State versus the input. So the input here will be A and B. And the states here will be Q0 and QF, only two states. So Q0 on A, from Q0 and reading A, where do you go? You remain in Q0 only. Now, from Q0 on reading B, you go to the final state, so QF. Now, from QF, on reading A, you go to Q0. QF on reading A, you go to Q0. QF on reading B goes to QF. From QF on reading B, you remain in QF. Okay? So, whenever you're going to write the answer, you should write it this way. After drawing the final DFA, let M equal to Q sigma Q0 A del be the required finite automata where Q is this, sigma is this, Q0 is this, A is this, first write and transitions you write and the corresponding transition table is this. That is it. So this is all for today's lecture. In the next lecture, we are going to solve more problems on automata. Thank you.